Hi there, it's Whitney, and I hope you're doing well. One of the things that I have been dealing with or thinking about is when we get to that place where we say, I give up, I'm done. And I wanted to shed some light on this through energy and through spirit. So, one of the things that happens is when we get really frustrated or we feel like we're spinning our wheels, we're giving so much energy into something and we get this amount of progress or no progress, we become defeated. Ugh, we feel so upset. We feel drained with our energy. Now, this can happen in situations, it can happen in projects, it can happen in career. And in relationships. Usually, in relationships, it can happen when somebody's trying to fix somebody or helping them. It can also be in one-on-one relationships, too, where you feel like, oh, I'm just getting nowhere. We're just going around and around. So, I wanted to talk about that feeling from an energetic perspective. If you feel like you are doing things because you have to, that's mostly why I just have to. I have it on my schedule, or I'm supposed to be doing these things. But you really don't feel excited about it in a, like, I get a push to do this. So, for an example, I have pushes, I call them, where I'm supposed to do something, but I don't wanna. That's different. That's what I'm saying is that you. If you just have a push to do it, even though you don't want to, then do it by all means. That means spirit's guiding you. You have spirit guides around you. But if you are just doing stuff to do it without inspiration, I say your spirit guides aren't really giving you the green light. What happens is we expend our energy so much on something that we get really drained and really tired. And we are trying so hard to get to that goal or that next place. And you know what we're doing? We're pushing ourselves away from spirit. We're pushing ourselves away from our intuition. And why we're doing this is because we're getting farther away from balance and our natural state of being. And if we're not being in the present moment, we're not going to get connected to our intuitive feelings and thoughts. So we can get caught up in the hamster wheel of thought or the rat race. A lot of times this happens when we're working on projects day in and day out, or we're just feeling caught in something and we're really trying to scramble to find a way out. And we think, I can't waste any time. I don't have any time to take days off and things like that. Now, I totally can relate to you if you're saying these things. I also have been there myself. But one of the things I have come to know as a truth, and I still have to constantly remind myself about this, is that you can't really fully see something or help something if you do not take time to balance and listen. One of the main things that I teach my students or my mentorship clients, and I talk about in the Four Intuitive Languages program, is that you have to clear your mind. You probably have heard that from me before. You've got to clear the mind. And if you're constantly in action and you're doing something, your mind is not going to be clear. So we need to make sure that we take time to, one, clear our mind. You can do that in some of the quick techniques that I've taught, or you can go to messengerofspirit.com/register, and there's a free course with that technique in there. You can also clear your mind through walking in nature or cooking. You can also just distract the mind, and that can also make it very clear sometimes, which is nice. Another thing that we need to be doing is taking a step back because we've gotten so close to something that we can't really see the bigger, higher picture. So we actually need to take a step back from whatever we're working on. Put it to the side. I know it's important, but it's causing you stress and it's causing you a lot of energy. So if putting it to the side is an hour, great. If you can do a day, fantastic. If you can go longer to put it aside, that's great too. Sometimes we just need to have that fresh air. We need to breathe, right? Because if we're constantly going, 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 we don't have that time to breathe. I also have used this example before, too. If you're nurturing something, whether it's relationship, whether it's health, whatever it is, and you're being really, really adamant about it, you could view it as you're growing a plant. And if you're constantly hovering over that plant and you're watering it, it's not going to thrive because it doesn't have time to do its thing. So what I'm going to say to you is whatever's stressing you out, whatever it is, let it do its thing for a while. So you got to step back from it. But anyway, you're just expending energy and your balloon is being deflated. And the balloon is the aura, your mind, the energy that you have in your body. And when you continue to work, 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 it just deflates. So you gotta rejuvenate that. Some of you who are really empathic might need to take that as alone time. Some of you might get energized by others and you might need family time or friend time. Whatever it is, just reset, okay? It's still gonna be there in the morning. One of the things my mom used to say to me was, it's okay, things will still be there for you to deal with in the morning if you want to. And she was trying to explain to me, just take a break, just stop thinking about it for a while. It'll be there in the morning. It's not going anywhere. But you've got to re-energize yourself. You don't want to be deflated. And your spirit guides want to talk to you. And when you're in those stressful moments, you're probably saying to yourself, where are my messages? Where is my intuitive feeling? I'm not getting anything. And it's most likely because you've built up this kind of like an energy barrier where it's really hard to get to you because you're going, 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 going. You need to take a step back. And that's when those messages or most of those messages from inspiration come in. Over the summer, I used to go outside and I would just say, I'm turning off my phone, I'm going to turn off my computer, and I'm just going to be. And my intention was to just be. But when I finally let my mind rest, that's when I would get creative insight on things. Oh, I've got to do this. Oh, I have an answer about this. So, being inactive, just being present, is actually a step that you're taking in the right direction. Don't think that you're being lazy by doing it, okay? This is just a message I wanted to share with you because I have a lot of go-getters, I have a lot of doers, I want to make things happen. When I have students developing their intuition, it's like they're looking for it. Where is the message? And the biggest thing that I can share with you and teach is sit back and let it come in. Just let it come into you. You're not going out finding it. You have to take time to sit back in your body, take a moment to breathe, stop thinking about it, because if you're thinking, your mind's not clear, right? And just let it come in. All right, I hope you're having a great November, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.